So apart from what I can program myself, the content for these machines can come on cassettes, floppy disks, video disks, via the telephone or via television.
Yes, you have quite a lot of options. But don't downplay what you can program yourself. Remember that programming languages are becoming easier to use all the time.
Well, I learned to do a little programming in BASIC, and that wasn't too bad. And Logo seemed even easier. But are there any new languages on the horizon that are even simpler than Logo?
Well, there is one very interesting system that we haven't talked about yet that will soon be available in microcomputers. It's called Smalltalk.
Our research group at the Palo Alto Research Center is involved in the development of software and hardware for personal computing. The information in the computer and the ways of dealing with that information are accessible to you, even if you don't know a lot about what computers are about. We don't think about computers as simply things for manipulating numbers or places in which you can present words, but we combine the numbers and the words with good visual presentation, nice pictures, graphics, and also sound. In terms of techniques for accessing information, a key presentation technique we've used is to divide up the display screen into rectangular areas or parts that people like to call windows. And so they're windows onto information. The primary kind of window that we like to talk about is one that we call a browser. We do this because too often we think of computers as being very precise machines in which you have to precisely say, I want this or that, and you get it back, exactly what you asked for. But the nice quality of a library is that you can walk around looking for something specific, but as you're doing it, you find other things. And that's what browsing is all about. A browser for us is a window cut up into parts, and each of those parts represents an access path to information. So we've been adapting the use of a pointing device called a mouse, which drives a little arrow or cursor on the screen, and you simply put that on the item you want, push a button on the mouse, and it selects that item. So that if I'm doing one thing such as text editing, and I realize, oh, I really can't finish this document because I forgot some information, I don't have to switch context by putting it all away and starting up a whole new program in order to find that information. I simply want to move to a different window on the screen, search for what I want, copy it, and paste it into the original document that I was working in. It is important that the language support making simple changes in an incremental fashion, so I don't have to be afraid that if I make the change, my computer's going to blow up. And I think it's that fear that if I make a change, if I do something in the computer, that I will cause something bad to happen, is the reason why people are afraid of the machine. We want to have a situation in which we don't have that fear, because one of the largest values of computers is that it is a good place in which to explore.